Hello students, in the previous lecture we have taken different antenna parameters. Then in that antenna parameters polarization is also important. So in this lecture we will take antenna polarization concept. So in the INSEM exam and also in the NSEM exam one of the question is asked, that is define polarization and explain different types of polarization. So for 5 to 6 marks this topic is important, so we will take in detail, that is antenna polarization. So polarization, first we will define polarization. So what is polarization? Polarization is orientation of electric field component of an electromagnetic wave relative to earth surface. Orientation of electric field component of an electromagnetic wave relative to the earth surface is called as a polarization. Polarization is important to get the maximum performance from the antennas. So this is a word important, maximum performance. Polarization of a wave, this is another definition. Polarization of wave refers to the time varying behavior. Your important hai. Time varying behavior of the electric field strength vector at some fixed point in a space. Time varying behavior of the electric field strength vector at some fixed point in a space. This is another definition. Accordingly, there are different types of polarization. Depending on the existence and changes of different electric field, there are different types of polarization. So first is a linear polarization, then next is a circular, and last is a elliptical polarization. So polarization can change as signal travels away from the source due to the magnetic field of Earth, and also it results in a Faraday rotation due to reflection. So keep in mind, that is a basic definition and types of polarization. So keep this definition is also important. Polarization of wave refers to the time varying behavior of the electric field strength vector at some fixed point in a space. So different types of polarization. So first is a linear polarization, second is a circular polarization. Circular polarization is again divided into two types, that is a clockwise or right hand circular polarization, or counterclockwise left hand circular polarization. Then third is a elliptical polarization. In that, first definition is a clockwise right hand polarization, elliptical polarization. Then counterclockwise left hand elliptical polarization. So accordingly, as previously mentioned, three types of polarization. So as per definition of polarization, this is a tip of electric field strength vector. Okay? So this is a linear polarization case. Then next is a circular polarization. That is a, in circular polarization, tip of electric field strength traces a circle. Where in elliptical polarization, tip of electric field strength vector traces a ellipse. So this is a ellipse and this is a circle. Tip of electric field strength vector traces a circle is called as circular polarization. Okay, so three different types of polarization. In next slide we will take more details. So in that, first is a linear polarization. In linear polarization, first is a vertical polarization. Here in vertical polarization, electric field going up or down with respect to earth surface is called as a vertical polarization. Electric field goes up or down with respect to the earth surface, called as a vertical polarization. And what is horizontal polarization? Electric field changing in parallel with respect to the earth surface. So this field electric field changing in parallel with respect to, changing in parallel with respect to Earth's sphere, Earth's surface is called as a horizontal polarization. So in detail we can see another next slide, that is in linear polarization. First is a vertical polarization. So in the vertical polarization, as shown in this figure, this tip of electric field strength factor is as shown in this figure, and this is a wave is propagating like this. Here electric field component along x direction is given by this formula, a sine of omega t minus beta z. Here omega is equal to 2 pi f beta z. Then next, horizontal polarization. As this figure in this figure, this is a horizontal polarization. So in this horizontal polarization, EY component, electric field strength component along y direction, is given by a sine omega t, in bracket a sine omega t minus beta z plus dou. So dou is a deviation. Then types of linear polarization. There are three different types of linear polarization. So you can easily understand these types of linear polarization. First is, when for a wave only ex component is present and ey is equal to 0, then it is called as wave is linearly polarized in direction, linearly polarized in x direction. In this case, the wave is called as linearly polarized in x direction. Okay, called as a linearly polarized in x direction. When wave is when for a wave only ex component is present and ey is equal to 0, this condition is important. Next, opposite to above condition, next condition is there. Similarly, for only for ey component is present and when ex is equal to 0, then in this case electric field strength factor E bar is given by E2 sine of omega t minus beta z plus dou into ay cap. In this case, wave is called as linearly polarized in y direction. When linearly polarized in x direction, in that ex component is present and ey is 0. When in linearly polarized in y direction, in that case ey component is present and ex is equal to 0. So linearly polarized in x direction mein ex component is present, but in linearly polarized in y direction, here ey component is present. So next, third case is combination of both, that is if ex and ey both are present and are in phase, then wave is said to be theta polarized. Then theta is equal to tan inverse of y by x. Here ex and ey, so you can draw. So this is a ey component. And this is a ex component. So this is ey component and this is a ex component. And next, circular polarization. In the previous case we have taken a linear polarization, then second case is a circular polarization. Here observe this figure, this is an electric field and which propagate, there is a 90 degree phase difference is there, and direction of propagation is along this direction, is the direction of propagation, and tip of electric field strength factor here traces a circle. In this case, tip of electric field strength factor traces a circle. Here if the wave is approaching an observer, its electric field vector would appear be a rotating counterclockwise. This is called as a right circular polarization. If this wave is approaching an observer, its electric field, electric vector will appear to be rotating counterclockwise. This is called as a right circular polarization, and this is a direction of propagation. So this is a right circular polarization. In detail, we can here explain circular polarization. That is the explanation of circular polarization. In this, if, as previously mentioned, if Ex and Ey are equal in magnitude and there is a 90 degree phase difference, then tip of the resultant electric field strength factor traces a circle. Traces a circle is called as a circular polarization. So words are important. If Ex and Ey are equal in magnitude and there is a 90 degree phase difference, then tip of the resultant electric field strength factor traces a circle called as a circular polarization. We know that for circle, equation Ex square plus Ey square is equal to Ek square. Here, as there is a 90 degree phase difference, then we can explain how there is a 90 degree phase difference. So observe these figures here. As previously we have mentioned, so this is a Ey component and this is a Ex component. So this is a Ey and this is a Ex component. Okay, when phase difference of 90 degree indicates that when Ey is at its peak value E2, so this is a Ey, this is a Ey which is at a peak value E2, then Ex is at zero value, then Ex hai kya, then Ex is at a zero value, this component is not present, Ex is equal to zero. Second point, as Ey decreases, this Ey decreases, then Ex kya ho gaya, increases. Here Ex is not present, but as Ey decreases, Ex increases. Then next point, as Ey reaches to 0, here observe Ey reaches to 0, Ey is not present, then Ex reaches maximum value E1. Here E1 is not mentioned, then Ex reaches maximum value E1. Okay, and so on. So as this explanation is going on repeatedly, that is when Ey is at maximum peak value E2, then Ex is equal to 0. Ey is maximum at E2, then Ex is equal to 0, and Ey decreases, Ex increases, and when Ey becomes 0, Ex takes maximum value of E1, and so on. Okay, so this is a phase difference of 90 degree, and this explanation gives an idea about that. Then circularly polarized light or wave. Okay, in that there are two parts, right circular, left circular. When wave is moving forward, as observe this lamination, wave is moving forward and field is turning counterclockwise, polarization is a right circular polarized. When wave is moving forward and field is turning counterclockwise, polarization is a right circular polarization. Here Ex component is given by A sine of bracket omega t minus beta z, and Ey component is given by A sine of omega t minus beta z plus 90 degree. Then next is a left circular polarization. When wave is moving forward and field is turning clockwise, then polarization is a left circular polarization. Wave is moving forward and field is turning clockwise, then it is called as a left circular polarization. Then Ex component is given by A sine of omega t minus beta z, and Ey is given by A sine of bracket omega t minus beta z minus 90 degree. So in exam, explain, define polarization, explain different types of polarization with its mathematical treatment. ऐसा क्वेश्चन आ गया तो ये इक्वेशंस जो है आपको वहां पे रिकॉल करने पड़ेंगे, ई एक्स ई वाई मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशंस. देन नेक्स्ट, अ सर्कुलरली पोलराइज्ड वेव एज अ सम ऑफ टू लीनियरली पोलराइज्ड कंपोनेंट्स दैट इज अ 90 डिग्री आउट ऑफ फेज. सो लेफ्ट हैंडेड सर्कुलरली पोलराइज्ड लाइट इज here, and linearly polarized light or wave is as shown in this figure. So this is a linearly polarized light, then linear polarizer, then quarter wave plate is as shown in this figure. So we'll take next slide. Then next is a elliptical polarization. So previously we have defined circular polarization. So words are important. If EX and EY are not equal in magnitude, so in circular polarization EX and EY are equal. Here in elliptical polarization EX and EY component are not equal in magnitude and also not in phase, and there is a phase difference of 90 degree, then tip of resultant electric vector traces an ellipse, it is called as a elliptical polarization. So we know that ellipse equation EX square upon A square plus EY square upon B square is equal to 1, where A and B are constants. So we'll take details of this elliptical polarization. This definition already we have defined, that is if EX and EY are not equal in magnitude and not in phase and their phase difference is of 90 degree, then tip of resultant electric vector traces an ellipse. So this is a tip of electric field strength vector traces an ellipse. Okay, so phase difference of 90 degree indicates that this phase difference of 90 degree. So this explanation we have already explained in a previous slide. Repeatedly we have to mention this explanation in exam. That is when EY is at its peak value E2, then EX is equal to 0. When EY decreases, EY larger, then when it decreases, then EX increases. And when EY becomes 0, then EX takes its maximum value E1. EY is 0, then EX reaches its maximum value E1, and so on. So this is a repeatedly process occur. Then next parameter is the axial ratio. The ratio of the major polarization axis to the minor polarization axis is referred to as the axial ratio AR, where AR is given by major axis to minor axis, and this is a major axis and this is a minor axis. Okay, this is a major and this is a minor axis. Therefore AR is equal to major axis upon minor axis. So major axis is represented by OA and minor axis is represented by OB. Okay, this is called as the axial ratio, ratio of major polarization axis to the minor. So this is a major polarization axis and this is a minor polarization axis, is known as the axial ratio AR. Then next is a polarization loss factor. So polarization loss factor is defined as the loss occurring due to misalignment of the polarization of the wave and the polarization of the antenna. So here PLF, polarization loss factor, is given by magnitude of PW cap into PA cap, where PW is a unit vector of the wave and PA cap is a unit vector of the antenna. For linear polarization, we have cos of phi psi p square, that is a magnitude square, where psi p is the angle between two unit vectors. This is the angle between two unit vectors. So what is polarization loss factor? Loss occurring due to the misalignment of the polarization of the wave and polarization of the antenna is called as a polarization loss factor. Then effective antenna length. So this is also important antenna parameter. The effective length of the linear polarized antenna is defined as ratio of open circuit voltage at the terminals of the antenna to the magnitude of the electric field strength in the direction of the antenna polarization. Ratio of open circuit voltage at the terminals of the antenna to the magnitude of the electric field strength in the direction of the antenna polarization. So effective length is given by this. In the previous derivation we have taken an effective length. Okay, previous lectures. So this is a L by 2 half, this is a L by 2, and total length is a L. Then antenna equivalent area, which is given by, that is defined as ratio of available power at the terminal of the receiving antenna to the power flux density of a plane wave incident polarization match on the antenna. So antenna equivalent area, ratio of available power at the terminal of the receiving antenna to the power flux density of a plane wave incident polarization match on the antenna. So effective area AE is given by AE is equal to PT upon WI. So PT is a power delivered to the load, and WI is a power density of an incident wave. Okay, so this is an antenna equivalent area. This is an antenna equivalent area. So in this lecture, we have taken the polarization definition and different types of polarization. So in the polarization, first is a linear polarization. In that, linearly polarized wave is again divided into three types, that is linearly polarized in x direction. So linearly polarized, next is a linearly polarized in y direction, and when ex and ey are there, that is when wave is linearly polarized in x direction, then ex component is present and ey is equal to 0. In linearly polarized in y direction, ey is present but ex is equal to 0. And last is a theta polarization, in that both the ex and ey are present, then theta is equal to tan inverse of y by x. Then next we have taken elliptical polarization, then circular polarization and its type, how this elliptical and circular polarization works in a lamination form we have also seen. So thank you. In the next lecture we'll start a new chapter. This chapter is almost covered. We will see any bit remaining, then we will also cover up. But at most this chapter is at ending stage. Okay, so thank you. In the next lecture we will take next topic.